had a baby. Now, if she pondered after all that pain, no wonder most women can bring a man to his knees with just a simple look.
My God.
The bottom line is that mothers are a very special breed. Mary pondered because that's what mothers do.
Yes.
They remember all the first.
Bless
you know.
Up, y'all. Bless
Yeah, the first cry.
Bless up. How you doing? Mothers out there. Mothers. You better bless up.
The first word.
You are chosen queens, honey. Yes.
The first day of school. The first day. When you think about it, it's hard for a man to keep up with the days on the calendar. Much less the child's first party day. Mm-hmm. And then another thing, mothers are often more intent and willing to develop in their spiritual life than most fathers.
Amen.
Most of you sitting up in here today said you know the law. And if there's anything to it, it's a tribute to your mama. Who brought you to revival?
My God.
Made you sit on the mourner's bank.
All right, come on, preacher.
Most interesting, daddy was somewhere down in the woods. Y'all help me here. Yeah. It was mama.
Amen.
Who helped you make that first important step? Where your eternal welfare was concerned. Do y'all hear me?
Come on.
Yeah. And you know, this is really sad. There are too many mothers are forced to feel the spiritual role of both mother and father.
Come on.
The key is very pundit because she understood the magnitude of the moment.
All right.
She had spiritual to fully appreciate what had just occurred.
All right.
To ponder means to think, to consider carefully and at great length. It means to play and replay over and over in the mind.
My God.
It means to have your memory stirred, to have your thinking facility stirred. You know, the book tells us that Jesus was Mary's firstborn child.
Amen.
But she had, she and Joseph had other sons and daughters. They lived in the same house. No doubt they slept in the same bed. They shared the same thing. But they did not believe that their brother was the Son of God. No, Mary knew. I said, Mary knew. You know, no parent, I'm not true, no parent knows what a child will come to be in life.
Amen.
You may bring them up as best you can.
Say that.
But then you got to turn the results over in the hands of God.
Yes, Jesus.
And then pray about it. On the other hand, Mary knew what Jesus would become. Yeah, he already was.
All right.
Y'all gonna help me here?
Come on, preacher.
In my sanctified imagination, I see Mary standing, looking out the window as a mother will do, watching her children just milling around, playing around in the yard, as children would do, watching, just knowing that one day this one son would die a sacrificial death at the hand of sin. Oh, she could have done like Jacob's mama.
Well,
she could have flipped him out of town. You know, hear me?
Come on, preacher.
But she realized, even though she had given birth, this child really didn't belong to her. Y'all help me here. I keep using the word key. The key is, she pumped. She remembered what the angel had said to her. One day, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee. During the celebration, the wine came out. Yeah, the host must have been invited. Here we are in the middle of the most happiest day of our lives.
Well,
and the wine had given out. But Mary was there. And by the way, she was the only one in the crowd that knew that there was not a crisis going on.
All right.
She found it.
She had a son that could do all things.
That she had given birth.
Yes.
To the winemaker.
Yes.
Y'all don't hear me.
Come on.
She told Jesus, she simply said, they have no wine. And Jesus went ahead after saying some stuff to his mama that I wouldn't dare say to mine.
Give them old waters.
Woman, if I'd said that, I couldn't have said another word. Woman, what have I to do with thee? My hour has not yet come. But you know, Jesus couldn't have taught me obedience had he not demonstrated himself. He went ahead and did what his mama told him. Turned the water
into
wine.
My God.
And all the while, she's pondering in her heart.
My God, Jesus.
Those of you who got children, you love your children. If I'd ask you to get up now, give a testimony, first thing you say, I love everybody. But there's not a one of you here would volunteer to give your child,
my God,
to save somebody you didn't know. Especially to save somebody you know don't like him.
Jesus.
But the book says, while we were yet sinners. In other words, while we didn't like God, Jesus died for our sin. I see, Mary, I'm still pondering. I'm still thinking.
Yeah.
I'm still imagining in my sanctified mind. I see her all those years watching this child grow up. Bible said he waxed strong. He grew just like your child grew. Do you hear me? Keep in mind now, he was both God and man. He grew just like your child grew. But listen here. Even though she knew it, all those years, 33 years and 6 months, she pondered, knowing what would happen one day to a child. But then the night finally came that Jesus was arrested, put on trial, abused, accused, misused all night long.
My God.
Somebody must have gotten the word.
Yes.
Do you hear me?
Hey.
Now, when you open the text, you read about the account, all those key figures that played a role. What was that? Judas had already left the scene. But the brothers were there. Now, I have no doubt. Many folks will say they love Jesus with that.
My God.
Hope that he had done special things for.
Come on, preacher.
With that. But Mary, I don't read where she attended the trial. But all the key figures that were present at the trial are listed in the book. As I said, except Judas and Mary, Jesus' mother. Judas had died by his own hand.
All right.
Now, I don't wonder why Mary wasn't at the trial. You know, no mother wants to see her child go through what Jesus can do.
Have mercy.
But at the cross.
At the cross.
She just had to be there. Because Jesus was dying for her sin also.
Come on.
All his life, she spent pondering, thinking, and remembering. You know, we do well today to think on Jesus and our relationship to him. Yes. And how his death had affected change in our lives. But just look at the woman standing at the foot of the cross. Jesus, enduring agonizing pain. Think about it. Had that been some of you mamas?
My God. Hallelujah.
You know your child.
Jesus. I couldn't have took it. Y'all bless up, bless up. Mary was a strong woman. A strong mother. Pondering all those years because she knew what her son was going to have to face one day. But all for the goodness and the glory of those that love God. We thank God for Jesus. And we thank God for a virtuous mother like Mary. Y'all give Mary some praise today for being such a virtuous woman in this world. Yes, bless up one of the most virtuous women ever. Mary, the mother of Jesus Christ. Y'all bless up, bless up. Have a blessed and wonderful day. I pray your day has been blessed. Bless up, mothers, bless up. Bless up. I love you, I love you. Walk with me, Tiffany. I love you, my daughter. I love you. I love you so much. I pray your day is blessed. My sissy Belize, I love you, and I pray your day has been blessed and wonderful. Bless up, my beautiful queens. Bless up, beauty. Bless up, darling. Bless up, bless up. I love y'all. I love you. Bless up, and I pray you enjoy the rest of your day. Bless up, bless up. I love y'all, and God loves you more. Bless up.